Today, let's talk about dragons, FU money, and a mindset that keeps us weak. In case you don't know who I am, I'm Tripp Lanier. For over 12 years, I've spent thousands of hours coaching folks to get out of the rat race, become an authority in their field, and make a great living doing the work they were put on this earth to do. And for more than a decade, I've hosted the New Man Podcast, which has been downloaded millions of times and can be found on iTunes or Stitcher. For whatever I'm about to say, keep what works for you and throw out the rest. Recently, I was on a call with a client. I've been working with him for about a year and a half. He's making a professional transition. He's changing the type of work that he's doing. And if we were to measure the progress, it's been amazing. He's erased tens of thousands of dollars of debt. Less than 2 years in, he's earning more than double of what he was making before we started our work together. He's working fewer hours, and he's loving his work because he's spending time with people that inspire him. These are people that are building exciting startups. Sounds like he should be stoked, right? Well, he was certainly excited by this progress, but deep down, he was far from feeling peaceful. And this was because in his mind, he'd set up some expectation. He had a fantasy, he had a belief that if he got to a certain level of success, then he would be able to escape the ups and downs and fears and uncertainties of working for himself. In other words, he was upset because he hadn't completely escaped some of the problems or dragons he'd experienced years ago. So as we talked, he said, you know, I just thought if I got to this point, I wouldn't have to deal with dragons anymore. And yet they keep coming. How hard do I have to work so that the dragons stop coming? What do I have to do? Let's talk about what's going on here. Let's imagine for the sake of this conversation that there are two ways to orient towards life. The first belief says something like, if I make enough money or attain a certain status or XYZ, whatever, I won't have to deal with uncertainty or the roller coaster of life anymore. One of my coaches, Phil Stutz, calls this fantasy exoneration, as in, we're going to finally get to some place in our lives where we're going to be exonerated from life's scariness and bullshit. And this fantasy has us imagine that there's some velvet rope section of life out there where we're going to be protected from uncertainty and pain and effort. And if you think about it, that's the illusion we're confronted with daily. Buy this product, have this body, attain FU money, or become important, and all of your struggles are going to disappear. We can finally live in peace. But that's not reality. That's not been true in my life. It's not been true for the hundreds of people that I've coached. Just listen to my interviews with Phil Stutz and Barry Michels, and you'll hear two guys who have worked with billionaires and some of the most powerful people in the world, the ones who seemingly have it all. And what have they discovered? Yeah, that the folks at the top of the mountain still have dragons too. Imagine that. Bottom line, there's no escape from the dragons. They may be fewer, they may be different, they may attack your health, your relationships, your finances, it doesn't matter. They're still gonna keep coming in some way, shape, or form until we die. That's just life. And what my client was experiencing wasn't that his life was shitty, it was far from shitty. He was experiencing the frustration and the letdown that this fantasy had created. His stress and suffering didn't come from the dragons themselves. They came from this belief that the dragons shouldn't be there in the first place. So this leads me to the second way we can orient towards life, which is to one, play big and create what we want. And two, understand that we're still going to get some dragons from time to time. And three, remember that the dragons are rarely as bad as we make them out to be. When we live from this place, we don't get caught up in the fantasy that we just need to make more money or have more shit or be more significant in order to escape the dragons of life. Instead of trying to outrun our problems, we focus on what we want. We play big by creating what has us experience more genuine freedom, aliveness, peace, and love. And when the possibility of a dragon rears its head, we challenge the very idea that we're at risk. We ask ourselves, is it true that this challenge is really that big of a deal? Instead of getting hijacked by that young, fearful part of our psyche that believes there's a dragon under the bed, we get a flashlight and we go take a look. And when we do look, often we realize, A, there may not be a dragon, or B, the dragon isn't that big of a deal. In other words, we're wasting precious time and energy. We're giving away our peace of mind to things that just aren't that big of a deal. Now here's the kicker. What if instead of exhausting ourselves by trying to escape all of life's uncertainties and problems, we took a look at our track record and we remembered all the dragon asses we've kicked already. What if we remembered that we weren't so fragile? What if we could remember that we've done all that we've done and say, you know what? I may not be psyched that there's a dragon here, but I can handle it. I can handle the dragons if they've come. I've done it before. This is how we find peace. It's not in the hope that one day the dragons are going to stop coming. It's in knowing that when they do come, that we have the experience and the skills to slay them again, just like we've done before. My hope is that when we remember how powerful we already are, that the peace and the freedom and aliveness and love we most want, we're going to find that it's much closer than we previously thought. This stance will allow us to enjoy what we've got right now instead of fixating on some time or a scenario that's never going to come. I hope this has been helpful. Here's to you experiencing greater freedom, aliveness, peace, and love. Thanks so much for watching.